إن الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. We are in the book of Adab al-Ashara. We are in the last manner. We are in lesson number 6 in that manner. We talk about شروط الصلاة, شروط الجلباب, and we mentioned there are 8, and 3 of them we gave in details. You carry on from there, inshallah. Number 4, أن يكون فضفاضا غير ضيق. To be loose, not tight. It's not good to wear tight clothing. Woman wearing tight clothing, that means she's not wearing jilbab. The men, they wear trousers. And the trousers are tight. Albani said he doesn't like someone wearing trousers to lead him in the salah. Because it shows his aura, shape of aura. Yes. We should wear either Turkish, what is it called, trouser, which is very big in the thigh. Or a Pakistani one, that two are loose. But other is not loose, especially European, very tight. And even sometimes you can't do ruku' if you're wearing that. Very difficult. So that's not count. So Muslim should wear always something loose, whether it is, whether he's man or woman. But woman, she's not wearing jilbab if she wears something tight. And here, in Musnad, Imam Ahmad, عن أسامة بن زيد قال كساني رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم قبطية كثيفة قبطي thick clothes garment yeah, from Egypt قطبك well known but it's thick yeah. كان مما أهداها تحية الكلب تحية الكلب كيف سنت برسول الله عليه وسلم كيفت. And among that gifts, it was that clothing. For Kasavta Imrati, I gave to my wife. And Prophet Hassan asked me, why are you not wearing what I gave you? I said, oh, I gave it to my husband, my wife. Prophet Hassan, Murha, فتجعل تحتها قلالة. Tell her to wear underneath something called جلالة أو قلالة. إني أخاف أن تصف حجم عظامها. But it's thick, but it's tight. Yeah. It's tight. So when she wears, yeah, it can give descriptions of her body. Where it's small, where it's white. So to avoid that, they have to wear something called قلالة underneath. So the top garment is not showing the size of the body, and socks is part of it in this case. Number 5, Allah yakuna mubakharan mutayyaba. It should not be perfumed or incensed. That means should not nothing to smell from her clothes or from her. Abu Huraira was sitting next to a masjid outside, and that masjid the people go to a masjid or go to the market. So laqiya imra'atan mutadayyibatan. He met a woman and was smelling perfume from her. Smelling perfume from her. Where she's going? To read al masjid, she's going to a masjid. So Abu Huraira won't correct. He's a knowledgeable person. And the woman listening to him, قال يا أمة الجباري, أمة, a slave woman, of Almighty Allah, أين تريدين وين كنتم؟ قالت المسجد. ما شاء الله، she came to go to the masjid. If you get time, we go through one hadith, how important it's a woman to come to the masjid. قالت وله because of you are going to masjid, because of that تطيبتي you put perfume. قالت نعم yes, I'm going, I'm a good woman. Okay. قال فإني سمعت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول أيما امرأة any woman تطيبت put perfume on her ثم خرجت إلى الصلاة and then goes to the masjid لم تقبل لها صلاة. Her salah is not been accepted. Why? Because she's wearing perfume. حتى تغتسل until she washes her body from the perfume. So the woman who is wearing perfume, that means she's not wearing hijab. A woman asking me, woman asking me, and they were debating hot them. Yeah. If she wears perfume, have no sense, incense, is I allow it? No one is going to smell. Do you smell yourself? Yes, it's my body, I smell. So how you be sure that a man with 1 meter away from you doesn't smell? She said, he doesn't smell. I said, did you ask him? Men are not the same as human beings. Yeah. Some of them smell better than others. Or some of them can see better than others. Are you sure it's not smelling? She kept quiet. If you're not sure, means you can't put any perfume on her. She can't put any perfume on herself. Sahih al-Nasa'i, عن أبي موسى الأشعري قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم أيما امرأة any woman استعذرت who puts on herself a perfume فمرت على قوم and he passed by people because normally the people sit outside houses are small and no air conditioners so she passed on the road ليجدوا من ريحها and they smell her fragrance. فهي زانية. She's adulteress. She's committing fornication. Why? Because of smelling the perfume from her. So the zina can be by eye, from eye, from tongue, from touching, from hearing, all that. Yeah. Walking to it, all that, inshallah. Allah protect us, inshallah. We have lecture of fornication in Usul Sunnah. فَهِيَ زَانِيَةٌ شِكَتِ الزِّنَى rewards ajr or sin of the zina because she put her perfume and went out and people smelled. Number 6. Allah yashbahar libasur rajuli. You should not resemble the clothing of the man. The previous hadith of Usama bin Zayd. We have seen the clothing the Prophet gave it to him and he passed to his wife. That means there is something in the community, men and women can wear it. Both, no problem for this. But something men wears and not women, the Muslim woman should not wear that. Al-Bukhari narrated, and Ibn Mas'ud and Ibn Abbas رضي الله عنهما لعن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم cursed was a curse in means. Means, oh Allah, don't forgive them. Allah's mercy are not upon them. Allah's mercy not upon them. Who? Al-mutashabbihina min al-rijal bin nisa. The men who imitate women. Those who are walking, those who are wearing, those who are talking. If a man imitates woman, there's curse upon him. He's going to hellfire. والمتشبهات من النساء بالرجال and the women who imitate men. The women who imitate men also curse upon them. You see a lot of women, they love to have masters and they walk like men. That's haram. There's a certain way women walk, a certain way men walk. Even some women, they take tablets to have muscles. Worst. So that is tashabbuh, sa'alab. A man was debating with a sheikh, and he said, men and women should be equal. When he finished, Sheikh said to him, Uskuti. Uskut means be quiet. Uskuti means a woman be quiet. So he said to him, Uskuti. A man became upset. He said, why are you addressing me like a woman? He said, you are not happy to be same with her by just the verb, grammar language, how you want to be with her for everything. Take pregnancy one day, 1 year from her, you be equal. If you have 2-3 years pregnancy, take from her and be pregnant 1 year. Which one is acceptable? Okay, she breastfeeds the baby. Go and breastfeed him, the baby. Are you accepted? So what equality you need to be? Each one have their own role, their own way, their own creations. If one of them come out of their creation to imitate others, the curse of Prophet is on them. They are going to hellfire. So something simple. Number 7, Allah yashbah. You should not imitate or resemble. Libas al-kafirati. Libas al-kafirati. The clothing of disbelievers. So disbelievers, clothing, if the woman, Muslim, wears, she should wear hijab. Say Muslim, and Abdullah ibn Amr ibn Azr radiallahu anhuma, قال, رأى رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم علي, on me, I was wearing, ثوبيني, two garments. مسعفريني has been dyed with saffron. Saffron is yellow color, which is not normal yellow color. It is a border, put in the water, and they put the clothes in there. Have bit color, yellow, shining. Yeah. So Prophet Hassan said, look what Prophet said. إن هذه من ثياب الكفار. These are clothes of the kuffar. So in that area, on that time, kuffar men used to wear that clothes. So Prophet said to him, فلا تلبسها, don't wear it. So he needs solution. Ibn Abbas, it's not easier to throw a garment and buy another garment. When you take your socks, you wear your socks as a khufayn. Question came, if socks has hole, what I can do? Ibn Taymiyyah said, The companion is, they had only one garment. How many socks you expect they have? And has not any delil that been thrown from them because it has hole and you can't do khufin. You have seen the istinbat, how it comes? If you know the life of the commandment's details, yeah, it will help you to decide and say about your fiqh. قلت أغسلهما أغسلهما shall I wash them? قال بل أحرقهما burn them. Burn them. This is the limit to clarify. It's the limit to clarify between them. Muslim is clothing and kuffar is clothing. بل أحرقهما. Number 8. ألا يكون لباس شهرة should not be fashion itself. صحيح ابن ماجه عن عبد الله بن عمر قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم من لابس وأفى وارس ثوب شهرة the garment of the famous pride vanity في الدنيا in this life you wear that clothes to show famous a lot of uses they try to select famous clothes ألبسه الله الله will clothe him ثوب مذلة humiliation clothes يوم القيامة on the judgment day ثم ألهب فيه نارا and then you set a blaze fire on him and his garment so that means the famous clothing is not something the Muslim wear and if the woman wears she is not wearing jilbab okay the men they can wear it and if they wear it the salah is valid but they will get punishment on judgment day That means they can wear it. Let me correct. If they wear it and pray, the salah is valid, but they will get punished because of this on judgment day. So in here, just a quick khulasa, it's a summary of what we said. شروط خلاصة شروط الجلباب استيعاب جميع البدن إلا ما استثنيا It covers all the body except what has been mentioned. And we mentioned it, the hands and the face. أَلَا يَكُونَ زِيَنَةً فِي نَفْسِ It should not be adornment itself, or attractive, or coloring, flowers. أَنْ يَكُونَ صَفِيقًا لَا يَشِفْ It should be, it should not be seen through to the body, to her body. أَنْ يَكُونَ فَضْفَاضًا غَيْرَ ضَيِّقٍ should be loose, not tight. أَلَا يَكُونَ مُبَخَّرًا مُتَيَّبًا It should not be perfumed or incensed. Number 6, أَلَا يَشْبَهَ لِبَاسُ الرَّجُولِ It should not imitate or resemble the clothes of men. Number 7, أَلَا يَشْبَهَ لِبَاسُ الْكَافِرَاتِ that resemble the clothing of disbelievers, women disbelievers. Number 8, Allah yakuna libasu shuhratin. It should not be fashion or something in the market on that time to wear it. This is the end of the 10th manah. And we reach now, inshallah, end of the book. You reach the end of the book. And before you finish, may Allah mercy upon the author, Dr. Salah bin Abdullah bin Hamd al-Usaymiyyah, in his advice in this 10 monaries. Also, may Allah's reward on the translator, Hamza bin Shawqi, bin Ahmed, al-Ishaqi, al-Ishaqi. Inshallah, may Allah mercy upon them. وغفر الله لهما وجزاكم الله خير وصلى الله وسلم على نبينا وعلى آله وصحبه ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين.